Good morning. Today we have with us Manik Mendis. She's actually a communication specialist and a social entrepreneur. He's the current executive director at Rainbow Resources Sri Lanka and Rainbow Institute of Communications Private Limited. Good morning, Manik. It's very nice to have you with us, and also thank you so much for agreeing to do this interview. I just called you a few hours ago and you were very enthusiastic because I believe we have something to share about your experiences with regard to online training and education. Good morning, Manik.
Hi, Amma. Good morning. Thank you so much for this privilege of being able to share my experiences, my insights. And also, I think it's really exciting to do this interview from home, because after several decades, I should say, of going to work, working from morning till night, being bothered with the hubbub, the mundane in the office, it's so exciting and interesting to have flexible time and to be able to respond to your call so spontaneously, which might not have been possible in office.
That's true. Now, you know, I have a question for you. See, I believe, Manik, you have been involved in training journalists, training the communicators, all that, during these past several years. I think you and I were involved in a project on, you know, bringing to memory some of the experiences people had during the war and during conflict times. I enjoyed working with Rainbow at that time. But what has been your experience? Have you been involved in any sort of training during these past 3 months, or have you been planning to do some training in these coming months, particularly online?
Well, actually, as Rainbow Institute is a social enterprise with our office in Colombo, but we also work with communities, with children, with youth, and with adults, professionals all over the country. We have our centers, which we have set up with US government support. But as a social enterprise, we believe in impact. However, having said that, profit and revenue is critical, because we do have to get revenue in order to make the enterprise work. So 20th of March, we had to close down the office. And then from 20th up till now, we have not had any revenue whatsoever, because we could not continue our paid classes or getting anything new. Hmm. However,
is it that this is the English classes that you are conducting?
Yes, this Rainbow Institute's communication arm, where we do professional English, business English, public speaking, and so on. However, I think when we closed the office on the 20th of March, we did not know what the future lies. Therefore, we had a meeting and decided that come what may, we will continue to work from home. Now, working from home at that time was very novel, because we honestly had not done that before. But I remembered how my Singaporean boss, who was a maestro in business and business development, when I was the first ever public relations manager at MTV and also MBC, my boss, Edward Ying, told us, "I don't really care where you do it, how you do it, when you do it. All I'm interested is in the results, quality, and meeting of deadlines." So that thought came back into my head, something I learned many, many years ago. And I decided that we will, without an income, we will continue, we'll venture into online training. So 20th of March, we closed the office. 21st of March, we started a strategy to start online training. It was very challenging at that time. 3 months ago, we did not know what's going to happen. We had some classes going on, so we invited the students to come online. We had to experiment with what platforms suit us best, Some were talking about Zoom, there was Microsoft Teams. By trial and error, we got our students on board. We also thought this is a wonderful opportunity since, you know, we have to work from home. We will invite all our alumni to come for refresher training free of charge.
Okay.
Yeah. WhatsApp groups of the youth, the adults, the professionals, different categories, and we had a very heavy schedule of online training. And that for the past 3 months, no income, working free of charge, but that gave us enormous experience, discipline, by trial and error, you know, we sort of muddled, learned lessons, and we got a very, very good experience on conducting online training. Now, I must say that Rainbow Training is very interactive. So it's this personal touch, the personal attention, the one-to-one that we give. So we work in small groups. Now, when we started our online training and invited alumni, of course, because it was given free of charge, people were at home doing nothing, we had an overwhelming response. But so we could not just, you know, have huge classes. We confined our groups to 15. So that every student, especially with public speaking, got personal time to interact, to speak out, just like in the normal Rainbow classes, we were able to do it. So for 3 months, we have been very successful learning by trial and error, and online training has proved to be so exciting and so very impactful.
I'm sure what you have shown will give you, you will be able to reap results. Life is such that sometimes some of the things that we start, you don't look at the monetary aspect of it, you don't look at the financial benefit of it, but benefits come in so many different ways. And I think this is a time to partner and to collaborate. As one thing that probably COVID is teaching us during this lockdown time, interdependence, having to depend on others, having to kind of interact with others at a very basic social level. You know, I got to know my neighbors very well during this past 3 months, so which I never got the opportunity. So probably even as you start doing this, we'll learn certain things that are applicable to our aspects of our society, you know, where online learning is concerned. How to get the people engaged. I think that's the difficult part. How has it been, Manik, now when you conducted these sessions, most of the people almost everybody would have been at home. So our workspace had invaded into our private spaces, right? And often, particularly during the month of April, you know, we didn't know how to get stuff, get essential items to our homes. And that was a bit of a challenge. With all that pressure and all that, and having to work, calling people, attending to their salaries, making sure that their salaries are paid, banks not answering our calls at the initial stage. We had a lot of pressure, challenges at that time. And I think we have learned also out of that, even Marvin Street, we continued with our work. And actually we were more busy than any other time during this COVID lockdown time. So my question is about engagement. It's difficult to make sure that the student is engage with your whatever you're delivering, the lecture or the lecture or the presentation or the demonstration or whatever, because the other person is in another environment and we only see the little bit from the camera. We don't know what other distractions are there. Sometimes they knock off their video because to make sure that it is because of the internet speed. Sometimes they knock off the video. I have to knock it off because the speeds are low. And we don't know whether they're actually there in front of the TV, what do you call, computer monitor, whether they are reading a book or something like that. So how have you kind of grappled with that, especially with children? When you, I believe that you also engage with a lot of children, you say, especially children. Have you tried different, you know, exercises and different ways to get these children engaged with your presentations?
Well, that was pretty easy for us because, as I said, Rainbow, the unique thing about Rainbow training is the interactivity and the personal...
Your whole methodology.
Yeah, and also that there are a lot of activities. So it's not teacher-centered or trainer-centered, but student learner-centered training where the teacher talks less teacher talk time and more student engagement time. So as I said, how we did it, like in the Rainbow physical classes, we had small groups. And at the beginning, we always made a note of the names of the children or the adults who were participating. I have conducted myself classes for 2 people, and there have been a maximum of 15. So when we know the 15 who are there, we keep them on their feet. And we keep on, you know, saying, say, for example, Amma is one of our students in a group of 15. So we make it very interactive and say, hi, Amma, so what do you feel about this? Amma, can you give your thoughts? Sunil, can you give your thoughts? So they are kept on their feet. And what was very exciting with the children, we could see, because of the technology, children are very good, but the smaller children, the youth are very good. Actually, it's the youth that are the best in this. But the small kids, we could see their parents in the background. Because even our email communication, WhatsApp communication was with the parents, because the children themselves. So we could see mothers, you know, coming, peeping, being there. We could see the mothers who normally don't come to class, and we could see fathers coming. And the most exciting thing was when I personally found, when I did some classes, that class, there were 2 very senior bankers in the class.
Yeah.
And they were having problems. I mean, they are very senior, brilliant, and both were very good public speakers. And when I was doing the thing, there were technical errors. And both people at different times said, wait, my daughter is there. I'll get my daughter to come and sort this out. Yeah. And the other said, I'll get my son to come and sort this out. So here we had children being helped by parents, and parents being helped, the older generation being helped by their young people. So it became sort of a family effort. And after our classes, usually, especially the children's classes, we get loads of feedback. And the feedback started coming from the parents. Recently, we have started a little competition where we have asked children to record speeches, mini videos, and post them on our Facebook. And these are getting, and share them with their relatives and friends. And it's so encouraging to see the response of children, a little boy speaking about the significance of Ramadan, and another little girl talking about the importance of always saying, I feel fine. So these children are doing with the parents. So this whole online thing has become quite a family affair. When we are doing a children's class, parents are also listening. I mean, I think it's just marvelous. And having said that, Amma, you mentioned that, you know, all the hard work we have done free of charge will have dividends. And I must say, we already see those results, because some of our top corporate clients, and we have even one of the best banks, one of the best banks in Sri Lanka, which has never come to us before, they approached us, and some of our existing clients as well, and said, oh, ha, we want to go for online training. Do you have any experience with that? And we were so happy. Wow, we have been doing this for 3 months. Yeah. We are veterans at this. So let's get going. Yeah. And we have done sample classes for the clients, and they are signing up with us. Actually, next week we are starting for two of the top companies in Sri Lanka. We are starting corporate training. We have also, you know, honestly, Amma, people like you and me, we would love to give our expertise free of charge, but then, you know, an organization is dependent. Yeah. So we also, you know, have to go back to our paid model for existence. Yeah. So we have advertised three new programs, one for youth, speaking leadership for youth. We have started our usual public speaking for adults, and we have also started basic spoken English for beginners or sort of preliminary level people. And we started advertising in Facebook. And I must say, Amma, we have brought down our rates by about 50% because it's online training.
But costs are much lower.
I must say the response has been incredible. The period of 2 weeks, we have got about 300 inquiries.
Wow.
That's something we have never had even during our physical training, where we advertised in the traditional media, but we have got enormous. So we are continuing now. We are very, very optimistic that whatever seeds we sowed doing free of charge is going to bring us benefits.
Definitely.
Because at the we have continued to pay our staff. Actually, I must say the staff, the trainers have been amazing. Their support at these difficult times, they opted to take a 50% salary pay cut because we didn't have money. You know, we are not a huge profit-making institute with big money in the bank, in reserves, but with our meager savings, the staff worked very hard. They said they are prepared to take a 50% pay cut. Many of them worked from home and they did a lot of work to make this online training, our project proposals successful. But even the caretaker and the cleaning lady, I'm so happy that we were, of course, they cannot do caretaker work and cleaning from home for the office work. They can look after their own houses and clean their own. No doubt. But we were able to pay them, and both of them called me yesterday when the salaries had gone into their accounts, and they just thanked me. They couldn't believe that, you know, even people who did nothing were paid. So I think the team and even some of our trainers volunteered to do free of charge our free classes. So it has been just a team effort. Otherwise, without the support of the staff, who have been so marvelous working round the clock, as you said at Marga, working even harder, you know, because we see the light at the end of the tunnel. And absolutely, we think this is going to be a very, very good preparation ground for something better, something bigger, where we can make a huge impact in Sri Lanka.
Also, Manik, I feel that is a good opportunity for us to take the linked language English to the masses, because if people learn English, their potential, their opportunities just, you know, go through the roof, because there are more opportunities to learn more and to kind of be connected when one learns English. And I do hope that Rainbow will succeed in all your endeavors, and I wish you all the best. And I believe God's blessings will be also with you, and as you, you know, look after the people of your staff. Thank you so much, Manny, for connecting with us very, very short notice. And I do hope that even Marga will be able to work together with you, and there will be opportunities in the near future. And wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Amma. Thank you. God bless you.